Namaskar. Let us continue with the topic. In the previous session, we understood how to find force between two charges using Coulomb's law.
Since force is a vector, we can write Coulomb's law using vector notation. We have already seen the force on one charge due to another charge is given by Coulomb's law. So we have already seen the expression, but since force is a vector, we must express it in vector notation. So let us see how we work with it. So let the position vector of charge Q1 be R1 and position vector of charge Q2 be R2. So we denote the force on Q1 due to Q2 as F12. So if I write F12, it means force on charge Q1 due to charge Q2. And similarly, the force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1 as force F21. So let us consider, say for example, this is a charge Q1. Okay, so and another charge is Q2. Now since I have to talk about position vector, I have to take some reference point. So let us say this is the origin O. So from there, the position vector of charge Q1, I'll say R1. So position vector of charge Q2 is R2. So vector from Q1 to Q2 will be R21, and Q2 to Q1 will be R12, right? So this is the R21, which will be in which direction? It will be in this direction, right? So what we are talking about, when will we use R21? When we are finding the force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1. Force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1. It will be the vector is from R21, which is R2 minus R1. Alright, as shown. So it is in this direction. So F21 is in this direction. Similarly, when I want to find the force on charge Q1 due to charge Q2, it will be in this direction. So that time the vector which we are using is R12, which is R1 minus R2, and it will be in this direction. Alright, now let us say what is unit vector. Why? Because whenever we talk about some expression, we multiply it with a unit vector. So whatever expression we saw earlier, what was the expression? F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R square. That was the expression. So if I am finding the force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1, that is F21. So I'll say F21 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R21 the whole square. This was the magnitude. Now if I want to express this into vector form, then vector F21 will be this magnitude multiplied by the unit vector. So unit vector gives you the direction. What is a unit vector? We have already studied that. Unit vector is a vector with magnitude 1, unity. And it has the same direction of that vector. So how do you find it? It will be vector divided by its magnitude. So we have written R21 is a unit vector, which is a vector R21 divided by its magnitude. Similarly, R12 will be what? Vector, unit vector R12 will be R12 vector divided by its magnitude. And you've seen both are opposite to each other. They're equal but opposite to each other because the distance between two objects remain the same. Magnitude remains the same. The direction has changed. So R21 unit vector R21 is equal to minus R12 unit vector R12. So how do you write the expression? So Coulomb's force between two point charges Q1 and Q2 located at position vector R1 and position vector R2 is given by F21. This is the force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R21 the whole square. Alright. Into unit vector R21. If I want to write F12, how will I write it? Vector F12 will be equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R12 the whole square into unit vector R12. So F12 is opposite of F21. Alright? Okay, so we saw that force on one charge due to another charge. We found the expression for that. So we found that it is equal and opposite, right? Let us now find the force between multiple charges. That means one charge is there. If there are more than two charges there in the space, then how the force we can calculate on one charge due to all other charges. For this, we keep these charges in the vacuum. Now, if we keep it in the medium, then what happens we'll be learning in next chapter. So here we are considering that the charges are in vacuum. Force on any charge due to a number of other charges is the vector sum of all the forces on that charge due to other charges taken one at a time. That means what happens? So how will I write the force? Now, force on charge Q1 due to charge Q2, then force on charge Q1 due to charge Q3, and force on charge 1 due to charge Q4. That means I have to add all these forces. So force on 1, that is F1, will be equal to force on 1 due to charge Q2. How do I write it? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. Now Q1 Q2 upon R12 the whole square. What is the direction of the force? R12. That's it, shown by unit vector. Plus, now I have to find force on charge Q1 due to charge Q3. So how do I write it? 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 upon R13 the whole square. Multiplied by the unit vector R13. Okay, now what I have to find? Force on that charge Q1 due to charge Q4. So how do I write it? Plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q4 upon R14 the whole square. Plus, and so multiplied by the unit vector R14 plus. So on, I have to go on plus the last, suppose n number of charges are there, then it is the force on charge Q1 due to charge Qn. So how do I write again? Plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Qn upon R1 the n the whole square into unit vector R1n. So this is how I have the force on charge Q1 due to all the charges. So I can take some common factor. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is common. Also Q1 is common, but right now I'm taking 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. So F1 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. I've taken Q1 Q2 upon R12 the whole square into unit vector R12 plus Q1 Q3 upon R13 the whole square into unit vector R13 and so on. So I can write all this. I can take Q1 common again because Q1 is common here, and also Q1. It is because I'm finding the force on charge Q1 due to all other charges. So Q1 is common. Then I can use the summation sign. How do I write that? But summation, then this is changing. See 2, 3, 4 and n. Similarly here. So I can put in this place a symbol I, where I is ranging from 2 to n. It cannot be 1 to n because 1 is already, we are finding the force on 1. So how do I write? I'll write it F1 is vector F1 is equal to Q1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 summation of Qi, okay, upon R1i the whole square multiplied by the unit vector R1i, where I is ranging from 2 to n. Remember, it is 2 to n because we are finding the force on charge Q1. So force on charge 1 due to other charges we have seen. Now if I want to find out force on say charge Q2 due to all other charges, say there are n number of charges, then how do I write it? So I'll have to write force on charge Q2, that is F2, is equal to Q2, right? Q2 will be common upon 4 pi epsilon 0 summation of. Now, when I say summation of Qi upon, it will be R2i the whole square into the vector R2i, because it is on 2 due to all other. But how will you write I ranging from, obviously 1 is necessary to n is necessary, but I will not be equal to 2. So how do I write it? I write it like this. Summation Qi upon R2i the whole square, I ranging from 1 to n, but I is not equal to 2, into unit vector R2i. So suppose there are four number of charges are 4, 1, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Then suppose I want to find force on Q4 due to all other charges. How will I write it? F4 is equal to Q4 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 summation of Qi upon R4i the whole square, where I ranging from 1 to 3 into unit vector R4i. Right? Is that clear? This is how you have to find the force on one charge due to all other charges.
Now that we have understood how to find the force on one charge due to number of other charges, let us understand how we do the vector addition to find the resultant force. So for that, let us consider some three charges. Let us consider positive charges. So Q1, Q2 and Q3. Let these all charges be positive. So we have to consider a reference point, that is the origin. So what will be the position vector of Q1 from O? Say R1. Position vector of charge Q2 from origin is R2. Position vector of Q3 is R3. Now let us find the force on any one charge due to other two charges. So say for example, force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1 and Q3. So I'll have to take one charge at a time. So let me find out what is the force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1. For that, which vector will I have to consider? R21. So force will be in this direction, that is F21. Similarly, I can find the force on charge Q2 due to charge Q3. Which vector I have to consider? Vector R23. Which direction will be the force? In the same direction, right? So this is force on charge Q2 due to Q3, and I have named it F23. Now that I have got two forces, let us find out what is the resultant of these two forces. How do I find that? I use parallelogram law of vector addition. So I'll get, this is the parallelogram and then this is the resultant. So this I name as say F2. So force on charge Q2 due to charge Q1 and Q3. I've named it as F2. This is the resultant force. So the similar way, we find the force on any one charge due to number of other charges. So I have to keep on doing this vector addition to find the resultant force on any one charge. That's all in this session. See you next time.